these NCRT exercises will be cakewalk for you. No point I'm talking about that. Okay, there is one instrument, Venti graph generator, which is removed from your syllabus. Okay, it's not in your NCRT syllabus, but still it features in your book. So let's talk about it, because it actually introduces pretty nicely the concept of how you can, you know, exploit the potential difference and create a huge potential. Have you heard of Venti graph generator?
Yeah.
Have you seen it? Have you experienced it? Experience it. Have you put your hand on it?
I tried making it.
Your hair is... Okay. So let's talk about this concept of Venti graph generator. Okay, before we understand Venti graph generator, we need to understand few basic things. Okay? Tell me one thing, that if there is a charge, okay, this charge kept over here, this is charge Q, okay, potential over here is V1 and over there it is V2, okay. Now, if V1 is greater than V2, will the charge go towards V2 or go away from V2? Basically, my question is, will a positive charge will go from lower potential to higher potential? Or from higher potential to lower potential? Higher potential to lower potential. Very simple. Okay? You already know that positive charge will move in the direction of electric field. Okay? So you can understand the same concept by using potential also. Okay? It is saying the same thing. Electric field will be, in opposite direction of increasing potential. So basically, if V1 is more than V2, electric field will be like this. Yes or no? Assume a point charge over here, its electric field will be like that, and along this direction, potential decreases. Right? So, direction of electric field will be in the direction of decreasing potential. So when you say that a charge will move in the direction of electric field, you are also saying that the charge will move from higher potential to lower potential. Fine? Okay? So, that is one thing which you need to keep in mind when we talk about Venti graph generator. Now, let's take two concentric spherical shells. This and that. This is radius A, that is radius B. The inner sphere has charge QA and the outer sphere has charge QB. Okay? Both are positive charge. Alright? Understood, right? Now, I want you to find out potential of A is what? And potential of metallic sphere B is what? Both are metallic concentric spheres. Okay? So, entire metal will have same potential. So I want to find out potential of the outer metallic sphere and potential of the inner metallic sphere. Okay? Try to do this.
The two metallic spheres are not shells.
Shells. So VA should be potential due to the due to radius, okay, right, V1 plus V2, here V1 plus V2, this is because of the R equal to V and this is because of R equal to A, this is because of R equal to V and this is because of R equal to A. So both inner and outer sphere, they will get the potential due to both these spheres. Are you getting it? Okay. So are they equal or they are different? And if they are different, what is the expression? What will be potential at point A, at this point, because of the inner sphere? How much will it be?
Q.
K into Q A by again, now tell me potential on the inner sphere because of the outer charge. K into, due to the outer sphere, this point is outside or inside the outer sphere?
Inside.
Inside. So potential due to potential inside a spherical shell is what? KQ by its radius. It is constant throughout. Right? So K into QB by
A. B.
Obviously. KQ by radius is the potential everywhere inside this spherical shell. This is the potential V1 and V2. The potential of the inner sphere will become KQA by A plus KQB by B. Now can you find out similarly potential of the outer sphere? K into QA divided by, let's split it, QA by QA by what? With potential at this point due to the inner sphere. How much it is? By B. This point is outside the inner sphere. Na? So for inner sphere, behave like a point charge. This plus K into QB by
B.
Okay? Now tell me, what is VA minus VB? If you subtract, you will get K times QA 1 by A minus 1 by B. What is so surprising about the potential difference? There is one very surprising fact about it. What?
It's negative because B is more than A. No, that's wrong. Possibly. 1 by A is more. 1 by A is more.
It doesn't matter what is the charge QB. QB is not coming here.
Yeah.
Potential difference. Even if QB is 1 million coulomb and charge over here is just 1 proton's charge, then also the inner sphere will be at a higher potential than the outer sphere. Understood?
Yes.
Okay. So if you connect them through a wire like this, how the charge will flow from higher to lower potential? So even if just one proton is left and here is 1 million coulomb, then also that proton will move out. Okay. So that potential difference becomes zero. When you connect, potential difference tries to become zero. And when that will happen? When QA becomes zero. Getting it? Even if QA is 1 proton's charge, then also potential difference will be greater than 0. 1 by V, 1 by A is more than 1 by V. Understood?
Yes.
Based on this principle, Venn diagram generator is built. Let's see how it is. No doubts, right? Okay. Now this. Hello. Don't talk. Draw this. Metallic brush here. which rubs against the bed. What will happen? Because of friction, there will be some charge transfer. Okay? So, let's say positive charge get developed. Like this. Okay? Then this positive charge with bend will move on this sphere. Okay? And then if you connect another metallic brush over here, what will happen? This will create a connection between outer and inner sphere. So what will happen to the charges? They will move out. They will move out from here. It will become a path from higher potential to lower potential. And till when this will happen? It will happen till infinity. If nothing prevents this, it will keep on happening. For every small amount of charge goes away, it goes outside as soon as this is touched inside.
So technically keep charging up forever.
Keep charging up forever if it is kept in vacuum. But what happens is that outside there will be air. Okay, air is not, it is kind of insulator only, but ultimately it is oxygen and nitrogen, right, which has electrons and protons. So if you create a huge electric field can go up to millions of volts, millions of newtons per meter, newtons per coulomb. Everything is getting recorded. Alright, so electric field, if it, I don't care if I am wrong without recording, but with recording I should be
possible. Only once. Only once per class.
Huh?
Only once per class.
Once per class. That too if you catch it. Okay, so these oxygen and nitrogen, if you create huge electric field, can break down. And it can create charge which could neutralize these. You have seen the lightning, right? During thunderstorms, huge electric field gets created because of the clouds, okay? And then breakdown of air happens, and nitrogen and oxygen will be acting like a conductor then. Similar thing. But if there is no air, you can practically charge it. And at times, it is, this Bendigo generator is also used to demonstrate electric field, right? It is used as a toy, you know, that you have a handle over here, keep on rotating this mechanically, and it just gets charged so much that if you touch it, if you touch it, your potential becomes similar to the potential of this. Okay? Don't worry, you will not die. Okay? Even if it is like millions of volts. Okay? Because you don't die because of potential, you die because of the current. Remember? Okay, so it is safe to touch the high potential. So don't try, I am not responsible. I am just saying, theoretically. Okay, but if loops get completed, if you touch this as lower voltage, this as higher voltage, current will flow like that. Right, as long as your entire body is at one potential, current will not flow. You have to wear some insulator. You can on the foot, otherwise loop can get completed from the earth itself. Okay? So high amount of current is required for you to leave the earth.
So this thing will be a few milliamps. Current will be a few milliamps.
Current will be a few milliamps. Even if it is like million if you just touch it also. So you will not die. But then your hairs will have good amount of charge on hair, so they will ripple each other, and in the process of rippling each other, they stand up.
So they stand up because of the repulsion between the hair and the charge on the
charge. Charge will flow, right? Charge will flow. Send it out. Okay. This is how Bendigo generator works. So probably this is one of the coolest things in this chapter that was removed.
Sir. So how can I one thing? Can be infinity charge, but how can we keep the generating whatever the steel wire, steel mesh that is rubbing against the bend? You can't forever keep the charge there.
You can. I mean, you're worried about whether that brush will get charged itself.
Yeah.
That you can just, once in a while, you touch that with a huge metallic object, it will get neutralized.
No, as in here, if it's a closed system.
Then not possible.
So, if you keep.
But let's not discuss all this.
You can keep the wire connect, the brush, the lower brush connected to ground, right?
Huh, so that the lower brush, his point was saying, so that the lower brush itself doesn't get charged. If it gets charged, then it will become more. See, the thing is, if brush becomes negative charge, okay, then it becomes more and more difficult for it to release positive charge. These negative charge will attract the positive charge towards itself. Although, practically you can have infinite charge on the metal brush also. Okay? But then, just to make your life easier, you can touch it with a huge metallic object so that you have to once in a while neutralize this metallic object. Or rather than touching that, you touch the brush itself so that it keeps on getting neutralized. Okay? And then touch the upper. So let's do one thing. One small measure, okay? There is this line which has charge per unit length lambda. Total length is L. Okay? Fine? You have to find its potential at this point. This point is at a distance of L by 10 from one end. Okay? Find out.
So is it like this?
What? You take a very, very small element over here at a distance x from this point. Okay? This is dx. So what is the potential due to this dx element at that point?
Lambda dx.
Charge is how much of that dx? Lambda into dx. The potential will be what? K into dq divided by x. Yes or no? This can be written like a point charge. Any doubt? So potential will be integral of this. And limits will be from?
L by 10 to lambda.
L by 10 to
11 at best.
Smart. Okay. What? This small charge of dx weight can be treated like a point charge. Potential due to this point charge will be charge due to that, which is lambda dx into k divided by x. This is a formula for a potential due to a point charge. And then just integrate it. And the limit is for x, x starts from here, which is from here L by 10 distance, then ends at there, which is L by 10 plus L, which is 11 L by 10. Okay? This will be lambda divided by 4 pi epsilon naught. Ds by x integral is what? Log x, natural log x. L by 10, 11 L by 10. So you will get lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught. Ln of 11 L by 10 minus ln L by 10. Lambda by 4 pi epsilon naught ln 11 by 1. Ln 11. Okay? Understood? No doubts? No doubts, right? Okay? Alright, so that's it for today. Next class, we will start the capacitors, and that will be the last class of this chapter. Okay? What is capacitor? Just like you use bucket to store water, there is a device to store charge. It is very difficult to store isolated charges. Capacitor.